The next talk is about pseudorandom functions in almost constant depths from low noise LPN, and Yu-Yu is going to give the talk.
Okay, thank you. So this is joint talk with John. And by the way, this is John's Chinese name. Okay, this is the outline of this talk. I will briefly introduce LPN, and then we show how to build a PRG with super polynomial strength in constant depths, followed by the final result, which is a PRF in almost constant depths. Then we conclude. Okay, we all know that the LPN is about solving a system of linear equations in presence of noise. So in this case, every bit is independent noise characterized by the Bernoulli distribution with noise rate mu less than half. Actually, we have two versions here. The search version says that you are given the matrix A, which is essentially the coefficients, randomly chosen coefficients, and the Y to find out X. And the other decision version is to distinguish Y from uniform randomness given the matrix. And these two problems are proved to be polynomial equivalent. And if you look at the if you look at this A, X, E, these A and X, they are uniformly chosen, and this E, they are from the Bernoulli noise distribution. And in fact, we can draw X from the noise distribution as well. So that means both the secrets, A, X, and X, can be from the noise distribution. Okay, and this seems to be well known, but we provide a proof in the appendix. Okay, and this problem, LPN, is believed to be hard. First, it represents well-known decoding random linear, a binary linear code. So it is NP-hard. And in the average case, for constant noise rate mu less than half, the best asymptotic, the best attack needs like this many, I mean, it's almost exponential, up to a log factor, okay, asymptotically. And we can also play with the trade-off between the running time and the query complexity. Okay, and but in this work, we'll be focused on the low noise LPN. And in this case, this noise rate is n to the minus constant minus constant. And so low noise LPN is believed to be a stronger assumption than the constant noise LPN. Because when you have lower noise, it only makes the cryptanalysis easier. But we don't have a separation. It's just believed to be a stronger assumption. So the best attacks need complexity like to the power of n to 1 minus c. Okay. And quantum computers are not known to have any advantages in solving LPN than the classic ones. So related work, we start with the PKE. And in general, usually we construct the PKE from the stronger version, the low noise LPN. But more recently, we had made some progress on this topic. We constructed the first PKE from constant noise LPN with sufficient hardness. And it's going to appear in this year's crypto. And for symmetric cryptography, we know how to construct PRGs, authentication schemes, and binding string commitment schemes. And in this work, we are going to construct a PRF, I mean, a parallelizable PRF. It's not the sequence, a parallelizable PRF in very short, very small constant from the low noise version of LPN. So the main result is that we first show we can do a polynomial strength PRG in constant depths. Here, this AC0 mode 2 refers to the class of polynomial size constant depth circuits with all those unbounded fine gates. And then we present a PRF in almost constant depths. So for any depths, that is super constant. any depth such as log n or even less. And this complement with the negative result that the PIFs with more than Quanzi polynomial security do not exist in AC0 mode 2. And there was some additional features about our PRGs and PIFs, and they have a secret key or seed with only sublinear entropy, but it has comparable security to the underlying LPN on linear secret size. And this can be understood by the fact that in low-noise LPN, the secret is kind of very sparse, and the Hamming weight is very sparse. So we can use very small entropy to sample, sublinear entropy to sample a secret of linear side secret. Okay. So if we normalize, represented in the function of the key size lambda, then we get a security, a PIF of security up to the power of lambda over log lambda. So which is essentially the same security level as the constant noise LPN. And with some technical tools like to extract Bernoulli noise distributions, and we use secret preserving reductions. So let's start with the basic definitions. So we are using the randomized version of PRGs and PIFs. So it just looks like almost the same as the deterministic version, except that this PRG has some additional public coin, and this adversary gets to see this public coin. Okay, so this is a talk about indistinguishability. And for PIF, so this adversary can have Oracle access to the function and the public coin. So quite naturally, we can ask if we can obtain randomized PRGs and weak PIFs from LPN. Because in this case, this LPN looks very close to PRG or a weak PIF, except for the noise. So quite naturally, we can maybe try to eliminate the noise, like we do run a learning LWR from LWE. But in this case, maybe we can try to apply some deterministic function to every few samples, and then just output the final result. Okay, and I hope that this could be a PRG or even a weak PIF. Because every sample is just a single bit, so it would make no sense to apply a deterministic function to a bit. So we need to try to apply this to a few samples. But this method may not work. Okay. There are some impossibility to result, saying that such balanced function does deterministic balanced function do not exist. Okay, so our approach would to use some secret sauce and to convert, use some extractor to convert it into Bernoulli noise. So here's our proposal. So we use a secret source, like it's actually the seed, and we use a extractor or a sampler, and we convert this source into Bernoulli distributions. And then all these X and E's, follows from the Bernoulli distribution independently, and we just output x plus e. And this function could be probabilistic, because we have the public coin A, so we can use them for free just to do the randomization. So that's the construction. It reduced the job to design a noise extractor. Here's the statement of the result. If we assume that a low noise LPN, then we would get a randomized PRG in constant depth and with very tight security, tight security, and with a seed of sublinear entropy. Okay, but before I show how to construct the extractor, let's start with the simple simple question, how to sample a biased bit using uniform randomness, right? Assuming that the noise rate is a negative power of 2. In this case, mu is 2 to the power of minus I, then we can just output the end product of all these I bits. Okay, then for low noise rate, the channel entropy is very low. Okay, so this is the estimation of channel entropy for Bernoulli distribution. Then if we have lambda uniform random bits, using this method, we can convert it into like roughly lambda over log n Bernoulli noisy bits. But this is not this is far from optimal, because in theory, we use uniform random lambda bits. We can convert it into roughly this many bits. So this method is worse by a polynomial factor. So and it was observed that actually conditioned on the noise sample, there remains a lot of entropy. So maybe we can use a universal hash functions to recycle the entropy from W. But here we use a more parallel approach. So here's the proposal. We add in a randomized layer. Here, all these edges, they are pairwise independent hash functions, and they are randomized by the public coin. Okay, then all these functions, they are followed by the end product, this function. And we show that using this extractor, we can extract almost all the entropy. So here's the extractor. It can be done in constant depth because pairwise independent hash functions, they exist in constant depth. Okay, here's other theorem. So the noise extracted is very close to Bernoulli distribution, even given the public coin, okay, given above with error bounded by these two terms. Concretely, for low noise rate, we can set here this edge of Bernoulli is the amount of entropy we extracted, and this lambda is the amount of entropy we invested. So we can, using this method, we can extract a constant fraction of the entropy, and we get the a PRG of super polynomial of polynomial strength, I'm sorry, and with sufficiently small errors, which is much less than the actual security of the ALPN. And the proof using these tools like Cauchy-Schwarz and pairwise independence, which is looks very close to the Crooked leftover hash lemma, and we use also the lemma by flattening channel entropy cells, like we take many independent samples of same distribution, it would yield a new distribution which is very close to a uniform distribution. So this term, the first term come from this part, and the second term is coming from this part, but I will omit the details. Okay, and actually we can also use an alternative approach. We can use a sampler. This time, the input, we use better randomness. We use perfect randomness. And we can do, in this way, we can do it deterministically and more efficiently, but still in constant depth. But in this case, we can save the XOR gates. The idea is we take the conjunction of many copies of random strings, and each random string has having weight exactly 1. Okay, we can take this many copies and then we take the conjunction of them to obtain a random string of roughly the same Hamming weight as the Bernoulli distribution. Okay, let's call this distribution. I don't know how to pronounce this this symbol though. But that takes the amount of entropy, the amount of randomness needed is 2 mu q. This is the number of copies, and each copy needs like log q random bits. So this is this gives the total amount of random bits needed to sample the distribution, and we show that this is actually symbiotically optimal because the amount of entropy is roughly the same as the Shannon entropy of the same of a Bernoulli distribution of the same length at the same noise rate. So this randomness efficient. And we show that if you sample x and e from this distribution, we will get the same end result. So we use a randomized PRG of seed length, of sublinear seed length with comparable security to the underlying LPN of linear size secret. Okay, but here's the proof. We prove that under standard computational LPN, it implies the computational version of this LPN using this noise distribution. And then we use sample preserving reduction to show that the computational version of this LPN implies its decisional version. Okay, the first step is a bit complicated, but I will refer to the paper. Refer to the paper. So once we got a randomized PRG in almost constant depth with polynomial junch, so we still need to construct a PRF in almost constant depth. So it consists of two steps. First step, we construct a PRF of a small super log n input size. And this can be done by using an NRA DGM tree of depths, of some super constant depths. Because we have a polynomial strange, so we can do an NRA DGM instead of a binary DGM. Just since we have n bits of output, we just pass them as n blocks, and each block consists of n bits. Then do this for depths of super constant. So we will get a small domain PRF. Then we just extend this small domain PRF to an arbitrary large domain PRF. Okay. Here we use the second step. We use the Levine's trick, generalized Levine's trick. So the idea is if you have a long input, you just hash it into a hash the input into long input into log n, super log n bits to fit into this small domain PRF. Okay. Then we do this independently for many copies, sufficiently many copies, and then XOR their output. So here are all these edges are universal hash functions. And actually, the original Levine's trick used only one single copy. And they already got a large domain PRF, but it's not secret preserving. So the generalized trick, we use many copies. Okay. And here we use a long key, but this key can be expanded from using our polynomial strength PRG. We can use a short key and expand it into a long key. Okay. So here is the generalized Levine's trick. So if we have a small domain random function, so for simplicity, I assume here all these functions are random functions instead of fuzzy random functions. Okay, and here are all the hash functions, and then we got the resulting function looks very close to a random function of the same input and output size for any adversary making. Who's bounded by Q queries. Okay, so here the statement is information theoretic. So we consider any adversary. It's not computational bounded. Okay, and this in a previous version we were selling this theorem as well, but we were told that actually the essential idea was like almost 20 years ago. Okay, so we only provide the proof in the appendix, a new proof in the appendix. We can show that actually using this method, the security is observed for Q equals to n to the super constant. Because here you have to make this term small, and to make this L to be like some sublinear term, to make this the whole term sufficiently small. Okay, so in the end we get a PRF in super constant, and the time advantage security is observed, and this Q is super polynomial, but it has to be bounded by n to the power of some super constant, and this super constant is essentially the depth of the circuit that implements the PIF. Okay, so this is the dependency. So to conclude, we get a polynomial strange PRG in constant depth, and the PIFs in almost constant depth. And the T epsilon security is actually better than the underlying LPN. So if you use in the function of the key size, we will get a security up to 2 to the power of lambda over log lambda against the best known attacks. And the annoying part is the dependency. This Q has to be no greater than 2 to the super constant, which is the depth. And open problems, it remains unknown if we can construct PIFs in constant depths. We can weaken the end result. If we can get like a weak PIF in AC0 mode 2, or maybe if we can use like more powerful components such as a threshold gate to obtain PIFs in TC0. So it remains open problems. And there are also other open problems, such as like to construct some more crazy objects from LPN, such as CIHFs and FHEs. Okay, that's my talk. Thank you.
Questions?
What's the relation between TC0 and this AC0 with superconstant depth?
TC0, it can additionally use the threshold gate.
No, but I mean, are they, one of them is a subset of another or not? Because TC0 with actual constant depth versus AC0 with superconstant depth?
Is it I don't know any connection between that.
Because I think Naor Rheingold achieves TC0, I believe, no?
No.
Doesn't Naor Rheingold achieve TC0 PRFs?
Which one?
Naor
Rheingold? Naor Rheingold, I mean from LPN we don't know.
But no, not yeah. From LPN.
Naor Rheingold, yes, TC0, yes.
So, and the complexity classes are not, you don't know the whether one is better than the other, right?
I don't know.
Okay.
More questions?
How does it compare to what we know how to do from LWE instead of LPN?
Sorry?
How does it compare to what we know from LWE, if you were
LWE, they have a construction. Like for certain range of parameters, we can get a PIF in even TC0 from LWE. But you know, LWE use a very, very large modular size, so we cannot apply the same technique to LPN.
More questions? I have a question. I want to ask you for an opinion. So do you think that weak PRFs in AC0 mod 2 exist?
I don't know.
Okay. Tendency, like I don't know, like 60% yes, 40% no. Or?
But they have this ITCS paper which construct a weak PIF in TC0 AC0 mode 2 from a very assumption which looks very close to LPM, but it's not a standard LPM.
Okay. Thank you. There's 5 minutes break to switch rooms.